Welcome to another edition of the QLZ Green Room. I am Mo Lightning. Your thoughts, your comments, your reactions, all of that, welcome in the chat. With that said, welcome to the QLZ Green Room, the one and only Bad Omens, everybody.
What's up? Thank you.
How you doing? I wish I had like a button to press to actually make that applause bigger.
Yeah. Studio audience sounds.
Exactly. Yeah. At least an applause sign to flash. But we got Noah and Joachim here, vocals and guitar. How are you guys doing today?
We're pretty good. Yeah. Joachim goes by Jolly.
Yeah. Call me
Jolly. Okay. All right. That's good to know. That's good to go. All right. Well, thank you for your time today. Obviously, you've been doing this for a couple years now. Bad Omens, seems like you guys knew something bad was going to happen ahead of time. Did you guys not feel like warning us about 2020? Or
we just predicted 2020. That's all.
We could have called them 20. That would be
dude.
Good band name. Like prior coming out of the gate as 2020, and then 2020 everything
just
cancels.
Yeah, oh my god. What a year. How have you guys been handling everything? Because I'm sure you guys were looking forward to getting on the road and everything. How's it been for you?
Man, it really sucks because we were on our first headline tour ever when the whole COVID thing like really hit the U.S. the hardest.
Mm-hmm.
And it was going really, really well. Like it was, the shows were great. The attendance was amazing. All the bands like had a blast together. We became really good friends with all the bands on the package. And yeah, about halfway through it in Cleveland, Ohio, it got shut down. And now ever since then, I mean, we try to find like the best ways to utilize our time with everything. So now we're just working on new music like nonstop. And we've been doing, you know, like acoustic performances and live streaming stuff. We've been
getting
active on Twitch as well. And also just, you know, working and producing with other artists as well, since everyone's kind of stuck at home. There's a lot of collaboration.
Well, that's good. I've been trying to tell people, and I say this every live stream, a silver lining of this year is end of 2020, 2021 is going to be outstanding for new rock because there's going to be so much. I actually feel bad for bands because there's going to be so much new rock. There's going to be like huge song next week, huge song week after that, huge song. I mean, it's going to be a cornucopia of awesomeness.
Yeah, I definitely think we got a little lucky with the timing in terms of just our band's album cycles, because we had just put out the re-release in January.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it definitely got us enough time to where, hopefully, assuming this pandemic ends by like mid next year, which I'm hoping is the case.
Yeah.
Who knows? Yeah, that's what everyone's thinking and hoping for. But hopefully by then that'll buy us enough time to, you know, work on our new album. Everything goes back to normal. And we just boom, new music, new tours, all that stuff, rebooking stuff.
All right. So the sign will be when you guys change the band name to Okay Omens, or maybe even Good Omens, then we know things will get back on track here. So with the songwriting, you talk about the collaborations and everything. Do you think your approach to songwriting or maybe the lyrics are different because of the pandemic? Like maybe deeper, harder, more depressed?
Not really. I mean, I joke about this a lot because right when everything happened, I was like, well, like we've been rehearsing for this pandemic for a while because we never leave the house anyway. So not much honestly has changed for us when we're off tour, just because, like I said, we always are at home just working on music and stuff. It's definitely given us, I think, more time to just hone in on and be aware of what's happening around us, especially in the world of music, and to like draw inspiration and see like what like kind of sounds other people are doing to make sure that we're like doing our own thing still, and that we're, you know, we're keeping and that we're doing something special and different. Cause the new music we're writing for our next album is just, in my opinion, it's my favorite stuff we've ever done. Like we're really crafting our sound. I think we're finding ourselves a lot with this new stuff.
That's awesome. And so who are some of the bands that are influencing some of your new rock?
The new rock.
It's really not bands, to be honest. It's a lot of the influence that I've been personally, experiencing is mostly vocally, just because I really want to do something different next record with my voice that I've never done before. And I think so far we're doing a good job of that. But I would say like The Weeknd, I'm a really big fan of this artist. This, I believe she's from Iran, actually. Her name's Sebdaliza. And that's the person I'm getting a lot of like vocal and hook inspiration from. What do you think, Jolly?
I mean, yeah, just I don't know because after the now that the pandemic is here, who's to tell that if it wasn't a pandemic, we would be doing other stuff. We'd be going, mm-hmm. you know, maybe to the beach, you know.
Yeah.
All of these things that you do on a daily basis, they do subconsciously influence you when you go to create.
Yeah.
So I can't really say that. I wonder if a song would sound one way if I was, you know, not a pandemic and at the beach in the mall and had a great day, went home and
wrote it. Yeah, it's hard to tell.
Versus staying indoor for 5 months.
one thing we are trying to do with the new stuff we're writing and on this new record is we found a sound that we really, really like that we're trying to just perfect, but also not overdo. So much like our first two albums, it's all like very different from each other, but there's like a central sound that I think it kind of, you know, levitates around throughout the songs that you can kind of hear in and out of them that is very just it's almost like lo-fi but like dark and like ambient but still like dry somehow and in your face. And I don't know, I don't want to like give too much away because I feel like we're onto something pretty cool right now, but I think people are gonna like it. We're keeping the parts that we still love that I know other people like are gonna die for, like the heavy stuff, you know. Mm-hmm.
Okay,
but we're doing it in a really different way, I think, that I'm hoping will people will appreciate as much as we do because we love it.
I love that. I love what I'm hearing there. I love that there's some other genres and whatnot that are influencing the vocals. I think it's great. The more different influences we get, the better the industry is going to be, because I hate hearing from people outside of our industry that rock is dead. So the more we can do to lift it up, I think the better.
I think sometimes rock has kind of done it to itself because a lot of like gatekeeping elitist type you know, figures and fans in rock and metal. And they don't really, by having that same mindset, they kind of trap themselves into a box because they don't see the value in where they can pull inspiration and influence from outside of rock the way that I guess Jolly and I do.
I don't put a genre on us. I think it's easier. I know that other people do, and they're very free to do so and tell us that we are this amount of metalcore and this amount of metal and this amount of rock. It's just like, I do not put a genre on top of on Bad Omens.
Especially not now. It's getting even harder because these days we're building, you know, the rock elements around the production first. We'll do like the production and like the electronic aspects and the vocals first, just to make that extremely interesting and different. Cause at the end of the day, there's only so many ways you can play like a chord progression with a distorted guitar and a drum pattern, you know? Mm-hmm. So like any way that we can make that way more exciting and different with our music is what we're actively striving to do.
I love that. Again, I absolutely love that. Do have a question from Tim, who is just discovering Bad Omens, wants to know if you guys done any covers, and if not, what would you like to do?
We actually did on our deluxe reissue for Finding God Before God Finds Me. We put out in January. The final track is the Come Undone cover by Duran Duran.
Yes,
nice.
We do have one.
And that was our first cover we did. We've messed with them before, and we've been asked to do them, but we don't really like to get too far into the covers because we don't want to like, we want to be known for our music, you know?
Right.
So it's not
something.
I mean, if we did a cover and it just blew off and became a thing, I don't know if I would be like happy about it.
Yeah, I wouldn't be mad, but I would be like, I wish our song would blow up.
Yeah, I get that. There's a lot of covers being released to rock radio right now, and I get it with the pandemic and everything. You want that comfort, but at the same time, though, hey, we want to discover some new rock. So I can understand that balance there, trying to find what's you and what's not you.
Learning other songs, though, because I think it's helped me as a songwriter, like just for my own sake, not to actually produce a full-on cover and release, but just learning like the chord progressions or, you know, like kind of diving into the production on other music just so I can be like, oh, I've never thought about doing that before. Or even like something we started doing on the last record on all the choruses, we would layer an acoustic guitar behind our like, you know, wall of heavy distorted guitars. And it just really adds this like shimmer to the guitar tone in the production that I think kind of helps it stand out in a different way. And that was like a trick that we had never done before that we heard about bands doing here and there. And we were like, let's try that. And it ended up being really cool.
That's awesome. But speaking of some of your stuff, of course, Jolly's got a guitar there. So you guys are going to do some songs for us. Let's do one right now. What are we going to hear?
I think we're going to start with Never Know.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's awesome. That's a thing we released from the reissue, and people seem to like that one a lot. So we're going to rip that one.
Excellent. It's all you guys. Thank you.
Yeah, great. I'm going to mute you now just so there's no feedback and play it. What's that root note, Jolly? Cool. Let's run it.
Show me you're better off without me. Choking on every word you said. We'll see. Don't breathe another word about me. Only and you can finally rest in peace. We'll see. When I go out into the world, I just don't like what I see. You could call it paradise, but it looks just like hell to me. Lying in between our memories, choking me, and I don't know which way to go. But I'm okay to never know. Lying in between our memories, choking me, and I don't know which way to go. But I'm okay to never know. Speaking in languages we can't read. No need for you to spell it out for me. For me. Swallowed up and I spit you out. Like a drug that just wouldn't stay down. Stay down. When I go out into the world, I just don't like what I see. You could call it paradise, but it looks just like hell to me. Lying in between our memories, choking me, and I don't know which way to go. But I'm okay to never know. Lying in between our memories, choking me, and I don't know which way to go, but I'm okay to never know. We'll see. We'll see. Lying in between our memories, choking me, and I don't know which way to go. But I'm okay to never know. Lying in between the memories, choking me, and I don't know which way to go. But I'm okay to never know. Lying in between the remains, choking me, and I don't know which way to go. But I'm okay to never know. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see. But I'm okay to never know.
That is amazing stuff right there. Noah and Jolly of Bad Omens here in the QLZ Green Room. You are lighting up YouTube right now. These people are passionate. I mean, like these fans, this conversation, I wouldn't even be able to keep up with all the comments if I was trying. How does it feel to have such a passionate fan base?
It's easier for us to not think about the comments.
Yeah, that's probably good. We can't see them.
I'm sitting here in my studio, in my couch.
It's great.
With a guitar, talking to a nice guy and plays. Let's just leave it at that.
I love it. Man. I really do. I talk about this a lot on my Twitch channel, but we really have some of like the best fans, and they're all just like
super supportive,
so respectful too, and like self-aware of like boundaries and stuff, and just like supportive, and just I don't know, it's a really cool thing. I don't know how, you know, we've all collectively accumulated it or how it worked, how it came together, but I think there's a lot of longevity, I guess, in our fan base, and just how I don't know how we carry each other when it comes to like live touring and live shows and stuff like that. Like it's just a really cool environment, and I love it. It fucking keeps me alive.
As he says, you guys are a family right there. And respecting boundaries is huge because a lot of people don't know how to do that. So if you guys got that, grasp onto it as long as you can.
I get that.
Actually, I was looking through your Twitter feed at Bad Omens Cult and noticed that earlier last month, actually, you guys like retweeted a tattoo, a fan tattoo from the song Suffocate. You have inspired ink that is permanently on someone's body.
Yeah, we actually have a lot of tattoos. We get tagged in a tattoo like once a week, maybe.
Yeah,
it's crazy. I like to shout out all the people involved on the artistic side of the band visually and, you know, give them credit because a lot of the tattoos I see people getting that aren't lyrics are typically like designs that someone else has made for us, whether it's a merch design or our logo, right. Like our crown logo that we put everywhere. Nick Raffillo, our bass player, made that. He's actually a tattoo artist in Virginia. All of our music videos and a lot of our like branding and stuff was our roommate, Ori Beginnis, who directs all of our music videos. So it's a pretty cool, you know, like, I guess team you would call it that we put together that doesn't really have any in and outs when even our touring crew, like we have everyone just kind of locked in and we're all just very like, we're like a machine at this point that I think is pretty well oiled.
That's awesome. It really sounds like great things are happening for you guys. And again, as you said earlier, sucks that you guys are touring. Cleveland, Ohio ruined it all. I say I'm actually from Cleveland, so I understand. I get it, but
I was just happy that we actually got to do it. We knew before we thought it was going
to
be canceled.
Yeah, the show itself might have even have been canceled,
and we were able to pull it off. And you know, everybody was there, had a good time. You know, so at least we ended with a good bang.
We had so much fun. We all like got on stage during Thousand Below set, and we started singing their songs crazy. And just took over the whole stage. It was so funny.
That's awesome. Well, let's do the second song. I'm assuming we're gonna do Limits, the song that people are familiar with, or at least QLZ listeners. They're digging it right now, I should say.
Yeah, we're gonna do Limits.
Excellent. Thank you.
All right. Is that root note? That record.
That's it.
All right. Let's do it.
You set me up as a villain, but you never mentioned the root of the problem. Took what you wanted and flipped it, but you won't be dragging my name to the bottom. So much unsaid, let me forget, I won't forget. Well, everyone's listening, and they know the difference. You're not failing our senses. If you're throwing me to the lions, you should know I'm not scared of dying. I wouldn't take back one thing I did, one word I said. But I'm gonna make you wish you did. Jump to conclusions, they fall for illusions, but you wouldn't dare try to stop them. You're going low at the end of the road, but that won't be the path that I follow. So much unsaid, let me forget, I won't forget. Well, everyone's listening, and they know the difference. You're not failing our senses. If you're throwing me to the lions, you should know I'm not scared of dying. I wouldn't take back one thing I did, one word I said. But I'm gonna make you wish you did. Well, everyone's listening, and they know the difference. You're not failing our senses, but you're pushing my limits. If you're throwing me to the lions, you should know I'm not scared of dying. I wouldn't take back one thing I did, no. with me to the lions. You should know I'm not scared of dying. I wouldn't take back one thing I did, one word I said. Oh God, I'll make you wish you could.
Nice.
Got it.
Well done. God, it's such a good song. One more time, Bad Omens. That's their newest, Limits. And I'm loving the comments. Again, you guys are happy. You guys can't see them. But, like, basically people are singing along. They're, like, typing along. Singing along with the songs. It's something else, man.
That's awesome. Yeah, in my Twitch channel, we made a lighter emote. When we play, like, music or sad music, everyone just comments a bunch of lighters.
Yes.
Yep. By the way, and somebody calling out, where's the lighter emote? So, talking about cuddle pits. Instead of a mosh pit, you guys have cuddle pits. Yeah, so this is absolutely amazing. BadOmensOfficial.com to be able to check out more music. Support the bands. Right now, you guys are creatively working, but we know that we're taking people off the road right now. The pandemic is affecting venues and the individuals that work backstage and sound and lighting. So at least we can do is try to support the rock and hopefully get you guys back out on the road here sooner than later.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can't wait. At this point, we're talking about just restarting the entire Cabot tour.
Okay.
Because so much time will have passed by the time I think we're able to tour again. We're just like, let's just do it again.
Yeah.
No, do it even bigger and better.
So you guys are talking about doing your own thing with your tour, but is there another act that you'd like to hit the road with?
Oh, so many. Where could I start? I don't know.
I don't want this question. That's you. Because I've asked this question a lot of times, and I've realized that the question is, the way that I look upon it, like, it sounds a little dumb maybe, but it's just like, there is really no band that I want to tour with because I want to be on top.
Right. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, always dream to tour with your favorite band if it's Metallica or Iron Maiden or something really sick. But it's just like, when I visualize myself in the future, I don't see myself opening for other acts. I see myself.
That's true. That is true.
It's top dog. And just as my own.
I feel like the final end game goal should be, who wants to tour with us?
Okay. I was just about to say, who should open for you on a future tour? Metallica, Iron Maiden, who?
No. Exactly. Metallica and Iron Maiden, they can open for us. Slipknot can open for us.
Yeah. No, I don't know. That's a very good point. I mostly just want to tour with my friends. You know, for me, touring is such a better experience. And for the fans, too, even, like, when they can tell that the energy of the tour is just so... And I think that's why the Cabot tour, the Killed and Born Again tour, our headliner that got canceled was doing so well. It was just the energy that we all had on stage and, like, joking with each other in between our sets and, like, all this fun stuff we did. Like, I think the fans could see that and they felt, like, really comfortable at the shows, you know? Like, they didn't feel like it was this, like, kind of uptight, like, industry setting where everyone's just, like, trying to be the coolest guy or the coolest band on the tour. Like, we're all just having fun. At the end of the day, I think that translates, you know, way better than some crazy big tour where no one talks to each other.
Exactly. No, we've been on big tours, on really big production tours with bigger bands, and this is still our favorite, like, tour today.
Yeah, I say it a lot, but I'd rather play in a small room with 100 people that, like, know who we are and love our music than, like, in front of 1,000 people where no one does, you know? And obviously there's a win and lose to that because you want to expose your music to more people
you
and
get
more fans. But as far as my favorite show environment goes, it's always more people that are singing along and having fun and being themselves, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah. Now, how do you think crowds are going to react? I would like to assume that people are going to be over-energized. This is going to be the first time they're getting out and really letting loose once concerts are back. But at the same time, there might be, I don't know, hesitation because it could be uncomfortable for some people. So do you feel pressure? Do you kind of bring people together?
That's going to be their decision.
Yeah.
To their discretion if they want to, you know.
I was worried about that myself. I was like, maybe when touring comes back, no one will go because everyone's just scared of, like, you know, being too close or whatever, or like the pandemic stuff. But I hope, and it's a lot to ask, that, you know, the institutes of power and the government or whoever will make sure it's the right call when things are good to go and the green light's back on for touring and stuff like that, and hopefully that it'll be appropriate and no one will have to be worried that, you know, it's premature or anything.
Well, again, I wish you guys luck. Thank you for your time today. Love the songs. Love the music. Keep doing what you're doing. Noah and Jolly of Bad Omens. Once again, badomensofficial.com. You guys stay safe, and hopefully we'll be able to see you in person as you're doing the tour.
Yeah, hope so. We'll have to meet one day.
Thanks again, guys. And thank you, you YouTube crazies that have been blowing up the feed. Appreciate you guys as well.
Thank you, guys.